Hi, I'm Nidhi Goyal from Anant National University in Ahmedabad. I am the Associate Dean for External Engagement, and that means I handle all marketing and admissions and placements for the university. So as you know, at Anant, we offer both UG and PG programs in design and architecture. And so let me begin with the Bachelor of Design program, where we conduct our own design entrance test. We conduct it in two rounds. One is before the board exams, and which is towards the end of January, and we'll conduct another round after the board exams towards the end of April, early May time frame. The idea really is to find kids with potential. So, you know, the question paper is not very technical. It's assessing your general awareness, your basic sense of scale and proportion, your eye for detail, your problem-solving skills, and maybe, you know, your ability to communicate ideas, not necessarily through text, but also through visual, you know, communication platforms. So that is what we look for in our candidates. For Bachelor of Architecture, we follow the NATA score plus, you know, 12 standard score combination to come up with a merit list. We also offer PG programs. So the Master of Design that we offer, we have two programs within that. One is the Integrated Product Design and the other is the Master of Urban Design. So for both these programs, again, we conduct our own entrance process comprising of, you know, you have to apply for the program. You have to appear for a telephonic interview, a written test, and then followed by a personal interview. We also offer two fellowship programs, which are one-year diploma programs. There's a fellowship for the built environment called the Anant Fellowship, and then there's a fellowship for climate action. Again, for both these programs, we request you to submit an expression of interest, a statement of purpose, and then that's followed by a telephonic interview and a personal interview. So yes, we do have sample papers from past years up on our website. I think a word of caution here, because we are a design university, we do not want to follow a set process at any point of time. So if the sample paper looks very different from what you eventually see in your exam, don't be surprised. But remember, it's important to have fun. It is a creative field, and if you're getting too bogged down by, you know, the stress of an exam, we just feel like it's not worth it. And we focus so much on the foundational competencies that we also believe that it's not something that you can prepare for overnight. It's something that you've done through your life. So just make sure you have your senses about you and you're, you know, relaxed and looking to have some fun while answering our exam. So we have made portfolio an optional feature in our selection criteria. And the reason really is that, you know, we find that a lot of kids are swayed by this whole idea that a portfolio essentially means a series of sketches. That's okay, but that's not exactly what is required for a design admission process. So if you have a passion area, if you're interested in product design, in interaction design, and you produce even one piece of work done by you related to that topic, we actually find that a lot more useful in terms of evaluating the candidature versus a series of pencil sketches and charcoal sketches and watercolors, etc. So I always tell students that if you do have a meaningful portfolio, carry it with you. Otherwise, it's absolutely okay, and you know, we can make do with the others. Honestly, I believe that for any entrance test, especially in the field of design, I'm not sure if coaching is absolutely necessary. I think what is necessary is a passion for the field. And then there are enough resources out there. These days, people are even questioning, you know, why do you need to sit in a classroom? Because there are MOOCs out there. So just preparing for an entrance test, I personally feel it's not necessary. However, you know, some people like the whole structured environment. And so I think it's up to each candidate that if you feel you thrive in that environment of a classroom with other peers preparing for similar set of exams, by all means, go for it. But I don't think it's a necessity to qualify for our exam. So at Anant, we believe in making sure that high quality higher education is available to all students, irrespective of, you know, what financial background they're coming from. So firstly, our fees are amongst the most competitive across any institute. And we offer very generous merit and need-based scholarships. So if you rank amongst the top 1200 for UCED, If you have a score of greater than 140 in NATA, or if you are amongst the top 100 ACPC ranked students in Gujarat, you get a 100% tuition fee waiver. We have a list of 150 schools from across the country, and if you are, you know, amongst the top students joining us from that school, again, you're eligible for 100% tuition fee waiver, and we have a reserved slot for female students as well. Beyond that, we have need-based scholarships. So when we send you an offer for admission, we send you a list of documents that you should submit in case you're looking for a need-based financial aid. And based on an evaluation of those documents, we determine whether a student is eligible for financial aid or not. We have not capped the number of students that will be receiving financial aid, again going with our philosophy that if we've already found a student good enough to, you know, offer admission, we would want to support them through various means possible to make sure that they are able to study at Anant. So an Anant interview really is just a way for us to get to know you better. What kind of a person are you? What interests you? What do you like? What do you dislike? What have you done through the years? How has your personality been molded through the years? So it's really a very frank conversation. And I always tell students that you can also ask me as many questions as you want, because the whole idea is that the student also needs to get to know the university as well to make sure that they are making an informed choice. So it's not something that anybody should be scared of. But I think the one tip I'll give is try and be as candid and as honest in the conversation so that both sides are able to assess each other. So Anant is, as we say, you know, we are aspiring to be a world-class university, and we're very, very committed and focused on that goal. So you see a lot of action on the campus in terms of, you know, transforming our physical infrastructure, in terms of the kind of faculty we are attracting, in terms of the kind of students we are attracting. I mean, last year, more than 60% of the students who joined the BDES program were from all across the country. So we are making sure that we take care of these parameters of diversity, quality of the class, so that the overall experience for a student is significantly enhanced. There's a lot of focus on extracurricular activities. We support students both through mentoring as well as financially to help them get exposure to international programs, international universities, including, you know, supporting them on their travel and visa costs, etc. So there's just a lot of action lined up in the coming years, and we take pride in the students that graduate from Anant, so, and we'll continue to support them.